With all of the efforts to keep produce safe during growing and harvest activities, it's crucial to continue these food safety practices in the packing area. Learning how to effectively clean and sanitize equipment is a huge step to reducing contamination sources. The FSMA Produce Safety Rule requires that you must inspect, maintain, and clean, and when necessary and appropriate, sanitize all food contact surfaces of equipment and tools used in covered activities as frequently as reasonably necessary to protect against contamination of covered produce. It's important to note the distinction between cleaning and sanitizing. The Produce Safety Alliance Grower Training defines cleaning as the physical removal of dirt from surfaces, while they define sanitizing as the treatment of a cleaned surface to reduce or eliminate microorganisms. A surface cannot be properly sanitized if it's covered with dirt and debris, which is why cleaning must always come first. Surfaces on or around equipment can be categorized into four different zones depending on how closely they come into contact with produce. Zone 1 surfaces, which are also known as food contact surfaces, come into direct contact with produce. Examples include conveyors, belts, brushes, or sorting tables. Because Zone 1 surfaces have a direct and immediate impact on produce, they should be prioritized when cleaning and sanitizing equipment. Zones 2, 3, and 4 don't directly contact produce, but they have the ability to be an indirect source of contamination. Zone 2 includes surfaces that are nearby or adjacent to Zone 1. Some examples are spray nozzles, equipment housing, or interior walls of washing equipment. Zone 2 areas are often hard to see and access, which can make cleaning difficult. Zone 3 includes areas inside the pack house, which could be floors, trash cans, or storage areas, while Zone 4 consists of areas outside of the pack house. The first step to cleaning equipment is taking it apart in order to access all surfaces. It's important that safety precautions are followed for this. The power should be disconnected, and the equipment water supply should be turned off until the machine is put back together. If tools are needed to take apart the machine, they should be clearly labeled, and workers should be trained on how to use them. If equipment cannot be taken apart, another strategy is to either elevate the machine or set it on its side to provide access above and below. Ladders may be useful to reach the top of tall machines, and mirrors and flashlights could be used to better see inside or underneath the equipment. Growers should experiment with different cleaning tools in order to find one that can reach the far corners or tight areas, as these are common harborage sites for bacteria. If there are any existing collection points, equipment may be tilted slightly to allow flow to a drain. Drying is an essential step to the cleaning process. Without adequate drying, the excess water and moisture could encourage bacterial growth. Fans or blowers that are designed to dry floors and carpets are excellent tools for areas of equipment that are difficult to dry. The packing area should have plenty of ventilation to help reduce humidity and bring in dry air. Areas around and outside of the packing area should not be forgotten. As stated before, bacteria thrive in high areas of moisture, so staining water or condensation should be reduced. In addition, anything brought into the packing area from the outside should be cleaned off before entering. For example, dirt and debris on the outside of bins should be removed, and foot baths at the doorway could help to remove any contamination from the bottom of shoes. The use of a sanitizer plays a significant role in the reduction of bacteria and other pathogens on equipment. When using a sanitizer, there are a couple of items on the label to take a look at. These include the EPA registration number, what the sanitizer is intended to be used for, directions for use, and the list of organisms it will treat. Two common sanitizing agents that growers use are chlorine and peroxyacetic acid. Chlorine is both inexpensive and effective if used correctly. A downside of chlorine is that it becomes inactivated in situations when it mixes with even a little dirt. Peroxyacetic acid, or PAA, is more costly than chlorine, but it is effective in situations that chlorine isn't. PAA is also approved for operations processing organic produce. Growers can use an Excel tool developed by the Produce Safety Alliance to determine what sanitizer will work best for their needs. Establishing a standard operating procedure for cleaning and sanitizing of equipment helps to ensure it's done properly each time. Any tools used in the cleaning process should have a designated area, and dirty and clean tools should be separated or labeled to reduce cross-contamination. Following all of the proper cleaning and sanitizing steps on a regular basis is essential in order to keep fruits and vegetables safe.